I'm hitting the woods with my ouch bleeper. Because we've brought Ouch and About inside the hospital.
Wow.
Dr. Xand, Dr. Xand.
And I'm hitting the streets to answer your medical mysteries. In the hospital canteen, Chris has his first call.
A question.
Right, I better go. It's from Lydia, who is recovering from brain surgery to help cure her epilepsy.
Hi, Lydia. How are you?
Good.
Very nice to see you. You had a question for me.
Yeah. How long does it take for stitches in my head to dissolve?
Well, what's the diagnosis, Doc?
Sounds like a case of how long does it take the stitches in my head to dissolve itis.
Ha ha, Lydia's in stitches.
Well, they should take about 10 days to 2 weeks, but sometimes the stitches can take up to 6 weeks to dissolve fully. Shall we have a look with the ouch cam?
Yeah.
Okay, so Lydia, I'll put that there. And then you can see the screen.
Look away if you're squeamish.
So the little black lines are your hair, and the black bit is a scab.
It's just creepy.
You know what, Lydia? I can't see any stitches at all. So I think that your stitches, they're already starting to dissolve.
That's actually quite cool.
OK, Lydia, well, you have earned yourself an Operation Ouch sticker.
Oh, sticker.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Unlike Dr. Chris, I don't have a fancy bleeper out here. How will I know when someone has a question?
Dr. Xand!
Oh, have you got a question for me?
Yes. Why can my shoulder blade stick out?
Wow! So what you have is things called winged scapulars. Your scapulars, your shoulder blade, and they're called wings because they come out a bit like wings on you, which is amazing. Normally, you have a muscle called serratus anterior, and that muscle goes under the shoulder blade and holds it onto your back. And for some reason in you, it isn't doing that, which means you can do this amazing thing, which is flap your shoulder blades. I've never seen that before. Well, thanks very much for showing me your amazing back. Bye.
Bye.
Amazing.
Meanwhile, my ouch bleeper's busily beeping.
Get a wriggle on, Chris. It's Harry, who has a condition which means he has trouble eating.
Hello, Dr. Press.
How are you?
Fine.
What is your question?
What is an esophagitis?
That is a very good question.
Oh, what's the diagnosis, Doc?
But I think it sounds like you have a case of, I want to know if Dr. Chris knows what an esophagitis is. Itis.
Ooh, a double itis.
You know that an esophagus is the tube that links your mouth to your stomach. So whenever something in your body is inflamed, we put itis on the end of it. And in your case, you have an esophagus that's inflamed, so we call it an esophagitis. And so when Harry eats, his esophagus swells up and food can't get down it, and he feels very, very poorly indeed. So Harry, can you show me how the doctors have fixed the fact that you can't eat food using your mouth?
They put a mini button in me.
A mini button? So what's a mini button? Wow. So that is now a hole going straight inside your stomach.
Yes.
So what kind of food do you have through the hole?
Just a special type of milk and some medicine.
And that's how you stay big and strong even though you can't swallow stuff?
Yeah.
So that's pretty amazing. OK, well, you've really taught me something. You did such a good job. I'm giving you an Operation Ouch sticker.
Thank you.
Bye.
Job done for today. Clinic closed. We're both ouch and about. Chris is hitting the wards with his ouch bleeper.
Apparently you've got a question for me. It's pretty cool, isn't it?
And I'm hitting the streets to answer your medical mysteries.
Awesome!
In the hospital, Chris is extremely busy doing his homework.
I did it!
Come on, jump to it. It's a message from Olivia. She's had an operation on her arm.
Olivia, hi.
Hi.
Apparently you have a question for me.
Yes. Why did they have to cut into my arm?
What's the diagnosis, Doc?
So it sounds to me like you have a case of, I want to know why they had to cut into my arm, itis.
You're out on a limb with this one.
So tell me what happened.
I fell out of bed and I broke my arm just above my elbow.
What happened next?
I had no pulse in my arm.
So you didn't have a pulse in your wrist, and that can be really serious. You have a big bone here connecting your shoulder to your elbow, and that bone's called your humerus. And you have blood vessels running down your arm, and then you can feel a pulse at the wrist. But if you break this bone, it can hurt the artery here and cut off the blood supply to the hand. So the surgeons fix the humerus, and then the blood can flow nicely down your arm, supplying all these muscles and the muscles of your hand. Well, I think you have earned an ouch sticker.
Okay, nice to meet you. Bye.
Bye.
Meanwhile, I'm out on the street hunting down quirky queries.
Oh, hello, Matthew. Have you got a question for me?
Why do muscles get tired when you're exercising?
When you're exercising, your muscles use oxygen and a fuel source, which is usually sugar. So your muscles can get tired if they run out of oxygen or they run out of sugar. But if you're lifting a very heavy weight, you get other things building up in the muscles like lactic acid, and they can hurt. So it depends on what kind of exercise you're doing. What sort of exercise do you normally do?
Press-ups.
All right, how many can you do?
5. How many can you do?
200.
Show me.
I want to see this. Great question, Matthew. But you need to train your muscles a bit more, Xand.
I'd like to see you do better, Chris.
Sorry, I'm far too busy. I've got a call from Alfie. He's just had an operation to remove his appendix.
Hi, Alfie.
Hi.
What is your question?
How does your appendix work?
What's the diagnosis, Doc?
So it sounds to me like you have a case of, I want to know how my appendix works, itis.
Over to you, Chris.
So, Alfie, you have a tube, and you have a tube as well that connects your mouth to your bottom. It's called your gut. And that gut digests food and then turns it into poo, which is the stuff you don't need. But dangling off a little bit of your gut is a finger-like dangly bit. And that is your appendix. And most people think it doesn't really do very much. It might store bacteria that help you digest your food, but you can live perfectly well without it. And we know that because in a lot of people, it has to be removed. Alfie, what happened to your appendix?
It erupted.
It erupted?
Yeah.
If the opening of the appendix into the tube of your bowel gets blocked, then it gets infected and then it can burst. Alfie, did I answer your question?
Yeah.
Great. Well, I think you have earned an Operation Ouch sticker.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Bye.
Job done for today. Clinic closed.